chapter is addressing controversies in trade policy. We have two main controversies in trade policy. The first is regarding strategic trade policy, and the second is regarding the recent debate over the effects of globalization on workers, environment, and sovereignty. We are going to address at the beginning the strategic trade policies, which is that the country may have some strategic policies regarding enhancing technological industries. Why? Because technological industries may have a diffusion effect on the development of the economy through the development of the industrial sector. From here it comes the importance of government intervention. Why? Because we want to subsidize the industries, the technological industries, to achieve such a strategic goal. The main reason behind strategic trade policy by government is that you know, when we would like to enhance technological investment, for example, for the benefit of the industrial sector and then for economic growth, what it needs from government to subsidize such industry. This is making some kind of market failure. And in order to address such failure, you know, we have to know the cost and benefit from such failure. We need to be sure that subsidized industries are going to affect positively the industry through the diffusion effect. And from here it comes that the reward on from a social perspective is going to be positive. In order to explain such diffusion effect of technological industries, we are going to refer to an example from Japan. Japan used subsidies in order to support semiconductor chips. This affected positively transfer of technology and the development of microchips, and this was a very important step towards semiconductors and enhancing the competitiveness of Japan in technological products. Now we are going to move to the second controversy, which is regarding the recent debate over the effects of globalization on workers. And when we are going to talk about the workers, in the chapter you are going to find an example from Bangladesh. Bangladesh used to be a very important competitive country regarding apparel and ready-made clothes, but this competitive advantage was completely related to low wages and very poor conditions of work. And from here it comes that if we would like to have this comparative advantage, the increasing wages for very poor workers in Bangladesh may require improving the conditions of living, the conditions of work, and this could may or address the very large gap between workers in developed countries and in very poor economies. The second point is regarding the relationship between trade and environment. And in general, production and consumption can cause environmental damage. From here it comes that we have a carbon tax, and this may help in order to address environmental damage, which means that if a country is you know, addressing negatively the environment, it is a good reason to use tariffs against this country, so it could be a reason for trade strategy. The last point is regarding who is benefiting from trade, which countries are gaining, which countries are losing, and here it comes that we are reaching a very important point regarding the trade war between United States and China. The chapter concludes with a discussion on a new study that examines the effect of a rapid growth in Chinese export on American workers, and the chapter is elaborating on to how extent that increasing the competitiveness of Chinese product and exporting this product into United States had affected several communities and workers, American workers. And from here it comes that regarding trade relations, countries should evaluate to how extent which countries are going to gain, which countries are going to lose.